Hi beauties and curls, it is Melissa Q. Welcome back for another video. Today is August favorites. It's crazy, but I'm ready for fall. The first thing I'm going to talk about is hair, as always. I love my hair right now, and I think it's because I forgot that I used to stretch my hair. And this one is a stretched wash and go with a little bit of heat at the root. I really do like this. And let me just show you a couple of products that I've been loving. This is the Curls Passion Fruit Curl Control Paste. I really do like it. I'm using it today. I like it because it's water soluble, which means that my hair can go back to normal and I can restyle my hair without it flaking at the edges. I really do enjoy this. I love the smell. I haven't tried the blueberry. Maybe I'll pick up the blueberry after this one because a lot of people say that they love the blueberry over this one. I just has had this one. I think this is the second one that I've gone through, but I really do like this control paste. I think it's great for if you want to remold your hair, but really slicking down the edges and getting some edge control, it's a really good product. Another one that I've been loving is the Bakura Beauty Palm Tapioca Hair Deluxe Hair Cream. It is glycerin free. I love this because it does moisturize your hair. By the way, I do need to moisturize because right at the crown of my hair is usually where it gets really, really dry. And I have not moisturized or sealed today. So I'm going to just show you really quick what I do. And so I just take it and I'm going to zhuzh the ends. That's basically what I'm going to do. Hopefully my hair looks worth something. But I just take it. And because it's an oil, it's a butter. It's a hydrating butter, so I just take it and I kind of scrunch the ends just to get it on the ends, but I really do concentrate a lot at the top. Let me make sure my hair looks like something. Okay, so probably tonight I'm going to turn this into a twist out, but this is a great hair deluxe buttercream. If you have thick hair, if you have fine thin hair, this is something great for the winter months. But if you have, I would say my hair is like in between. It's still fine thin, but I just have a lot of hair. But I really do like this and it would always be in my stash. Another item that will be always in my stash is the Curl Rehab. Let me get it really quick. This product right here is amazing. I won't be left. This will forever be in my stash. It's a great deep conditioner. It's Now it is marketed as a moisturizing hair treatment. I love it for a leave-in as well. If you have dry hair, if you're high porosity, this is a glycerin-free deep conditioner. And so I absolutely love this one. It is pricey, but Curl Rehab has two sales out of the year, and it's the Easter sale and like Black Friday. So I really do enjoy this. Most of the time I will go in and split halfway with a curl friend, but I really do enjoy this. This is 32 ounces. This is the item I'm going to get because this one gives you more for your money, but I really do enjoy the Curl Junkie Curl Rehab Moisturizing Hair Treatment. Is the bomb. Joe is smiling. Come here, Joe. Come around here. He always loves being in my videos now. Come on. You are so funny. Say hi, everybody. Say hi.
Hi.
Blow a kiss. Okay, go bye-bye. Okay, so the next item I'm going to talk about is a moisturizer. I have been loving the Belief True Cream Aqua Bomb. This is the bomb. It is so good. I have two of these. I have a travel size, which is amazing. Whether if you have oily, this to me, it says that it is an increased hydrating level of moisture. I love this. It's by the brand Belief. And it smells so fresh, so clean. It reminds me of the Laneige. If you have Laneige, you won't need this. But I feel like that this is a tad bit more hydrating than the Water Cream by Laneige. But both of those are so great. But I really do enjoy this. You do get, what is this? 1.68 ounces. So you get more than an ounce. I really do enjoy this. And I feel like that this could work for sensitive skin, for normal to dry. It could oily because it's a gel cream. I feel like that this is really good if in the winter months, as you go along, if you have oily skin, this is something that's still going to hydrate your skin, but at the same time, give you some great hydration. It's amazing. I feel like any skin type could wear something like this. The next thing I have been loving, two primers I'm gonna talk about, Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water. This is the second one. I actually went through one through my Project Pan. I'm already halfway through, and it's because I actually refill the Fix Plus, the small travel size one with this. It's not the same as Fix Plus, but it is a great glycerin-free primer. If you have oily skin, this is also great just because it's going to hydrate your skin. It's going to prime the skin. It's going to, in terms of making my makeup last longer, I don't know, but it does make everything fuse together. It does kind of like the same thing as Fix Plus, but before, not after. I like that it's silicone free. It is alcohol free. So if you are feeling like primers are drying your skin out, this is something that's going to really, it's not going to do that, but I really do enjoy this. I feel like it is, I picked this up during the 21 Days of Beauty. I don't ever pay full price. I feel like $32 for this is a bit pricey, but it is at the same time worth it. Would I pay full price? Not if you're giving it to me on sale. No. So I will continue to get this on sale. I do have a couple of bottles of that. Another item is this is the Becca Backlight Priming Filter. I have been loving this, mixing it with this moisturizer by Murad. I talked about this in my last favorites video, so I'm not going to talk about this one again. But this, I love. It gives me a nice glow under my skin. I feel like it's a glow primer. I don't necessarily use it as something to, like, I don't really have pores, a pore problem, so I don't use it for that. But definitely for, like, highlighting and bringing some glow to my skin. If I wanted to go in with a light foundation or no foundation at all, and I mix this with my moisturizer and wanted to walk out the door with a little bit of concealer, I definitely would do this. But I really do enjoy this, and I would pick this back up again just because of the nice glow that I get. Okay, Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. Of course, the Born This Way has trumped this, but I have been enjoying this. The thing about Giorgio Armani, let me tell you, they have, like, the olive undertone. I think you see a lot of brown girls loving this because the undertone is so nice. So this is in the shade number 9. Two pumps of this, and this is what I have on today. I do have this in the Project Pan. I want to use this up before it expires. I do have a video talking about this. I'll link it over there so you guys can check it out. But it is a beautiful foundation. If the Born This Way was not in my collection, this is something that I definitely would pick up. But it's $62. I feel like you get the same glow with more coverage from the Born This Way. I think that one will last longer, and it's like half the price of this. So will I pick this back up? I still would. And I think it's just because of the undertone. It's such a beautiful finish. I get the same thing as the Born This Way, but I still would pick this up. That's crazy that these are alike, but I still would pick it up. It's something about the Luminous Silk, though, that the finish is, like, flawless. I don't know. It's a favorite. I used it all month. Okay. And the next thing I want to talk about, I'm going back to skincare for a minute. The Luna Sleeping Oil by Sunday Riley. Hands down, one of my favorite, like, night oils / retinols / skincare products. This is amazing if you want to correct some things about your skin, the texture. I definitely feel like that this is a corrector, and it is a retinol oil. So I really do love that. So I get the hydration plus some anti-aging. This Becca palette, oh my goodness. I got this during a holiday collection, I think. This is the Blush with Light Blush Trio Palette by Becca. I am in love with Becca blushes. Okay. Becca, Hourglass, and I'm going to talk about another trio palette. I feel like if I had this with some different shades, I would be good. I wish they had, like, these are pretty much pinks. I wish I had a coral palette like this. And I'm going to talk about this. This is the Balm Girls Escape Getaway. I feel like that these are more neutral shades. So if I had this, and maybe, like, a coral palette, I would be good to go in the blush category. But I have been loving these. Today I have on Wisteria, but I also have been loving Snapdragon, which is this beautiful color right here, which I feel like is also in the Christy Teigen palette, but I really do love that shade. So I ain't mad that I got two of them, but I really do love it. And it is a neutral, it stays on all day. I have a problem now with blushes that don't stay on all day. So the Balm, Becca, Hourglass, NARS, and MAC Shadow, MAC Blushes are the Balm. I feel like that those are the long lasting, and Tarte. Excuse me, Tarte. But this is from the Nutcracker Sweet Copper Face Compact. Y'all, this, what is this? Pleasure Model is the Balm. If you can find anything like it, maybe I can come with, it looks like I haven't even touched it, but I've been using it. And Whisper of Guilt. This is such a beautiful gold. I feel like it really complements brown skin. It is beautiful. So those, I love these by Persona. Hands down, my favorite liquid lipstick. Y'all know I'm a classic lipstick wearer. So when I say that I love a liquid lipstick, I love it. This Smashbox Dose of Colors, those are probably like my hands down, my favorite lipstick, liquid lipstick formula. Y'all, these are so comfortable. I have on today, OG. I love these. First of all, I love the names because it really resonates. Holy Grail is the most beautiful red that I have ever seen in my life. And I've been seeing so many people with this color on. I'm not a red lipstick wearer, but this looks so good on. I will show a picture of on my Instagram, and I will leave a link down below. This is so beautiful if you want to see a picture of it, if I don't have it in this video. And then also I have, this is from season one, so I guess there's going to be a season two and all of that. But this is Flamingo. This is a beautiful pink. I also have a picture on Instagram. And then I need to take a picture of OG. This is the most beautiful neutral shade. Sona did such an amazing job, and the Persona team, Persona Cosmetics, to me, should get more hype. It's definitely a brand that should get more hype, along with Makeup Geek. I am back in love with their shadows because I wanted to give them some love, because Makeup Geek has been, you know, in the cut with everybody. I have one more palette and then I'm done with makeup. My favorite palette for the month, I'm gonna put this in a pan, that palette, but this is the Modern Renaissance. I am so tired of the Lorac Pro 1. I'm actually gonna declutter it. I have some palettes on the chopping block and I will show that in a different video, but I have been loving this. This is what I have on my eyes today. I used Burnt Orange, Venetian Red, Red Ochre, and Realgar on my eyes. Oh, and I used a little bit of Vermeer right on the first quarter of my lid and the inner corner. I love this, seriously. And Modern Renaissance palettes, well, the Anastasia palettes are by far my favorite, along with Too Faced. I feel like if I had those two brands, although I do want to get the Born to Run. I've been seeing that and I'm decluttering some palettes and I'm going to replace that one once I get rid of some palettes. I will purchase that a little bit later, but yeah, those have been my favorites for the month. Let's get into shows on Netflix. I just finished The Originals. So sad at the end. So sad. Season 5. Yes, I really enjoyed that. So let's see. I still have to finish The Punisher and anything Marvel. Well, I haven't even done Luke Cage yet, season 2. Let me know if that's good, y'all. But comment down below. Let me know what your favorite Netflix shows are, because I need to find a new one, because I like doing them one at a time. Oh, the Mayans, y'all, are coming out. You remember Sons of Anarchy? I was a Sons of Anarchy. Me and my husband binge watched that. So we're excited about the Mayans. Yes. So I'm about to leave anyway. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. We are leaving, getting up out of here. I gotta go, but I wanted to show you guys my favorites for the month of August. Comment down below. Let me know what your favorites are and leave me some Netflix shows. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you beautiful you in the next video. Bye, guys.